Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Yes guys, Sweden. I would like to just point out right away with a quick disclaimer, the Swedish tech tree is not coming with update 1.93, only the premiums are. So it's going to be similar to how they're doing like the Japanese helicopters, the Italian helicopter, or back in the day with the British Ground Forces pre-orders that you could get. There was only like 4 premiums, but no actual tech tree. That's what it's going to be like now. The actual Swedish tech tree will come to the game in the future with probably update 1.95 or maybe an update after that. I don't exactly know. And this is for the aviation tech tree, not the ground tech tree. But it was said that the ground and apparently naval tech tree will come at a later date too. Now the reason I'm a little bit late getting to this is because I was busy doing some things, and I also watched the live stream that they did today, both the English and Russian live stream, to look at some of the new stuff. There's a lot of really interesting stuff coming. Germany is getting a BMP. You know, France is getting an F-100. There is new premium light cruisers, like the light cruiser for the United States, as well as, of course, a new heavy cruiser. The other heavy cruiser that wasn't the Pensacola that we saw in the last devlog, the other one is a British heavy cruiser that they didn't show off in the live stream, I guess, because the model isn't ready yet. But, of course, one of the first things that they showed off was that Sweden is coming to the game now. Again, not the full tech trees, but it'll be coming in the form of 2 premium aircraft, and this is a dev blog on the first of the premium aircraft, but you could see both of them in the live stream itself. So this is the a premium Swedish jet aircraft, and the other premium, which will be the lower tier premium, was a Finnish fighter plane. So it looks like they're going to be combining Sweden and Finland together at least. Which is kind of interesting. There's a lot of possibilities there with different combinations. And the Finnish plane, by the way, looks gorgeous. And that's probably the one that I think I'm going to be a little bit more interested in. But either way, well, we kind of knew Sweden would come to the game someday, but how soon? Didn't know it was going to be this soon. That definitely caught me off guard. And yeah. Also, another thing, in case they don't do a dev blog on it, but I hope they do, China is also getting a ZTZ in the next update, so they're finally getting a proper main battle tank for their nation, and it looks fucking amazing. So hopefully they do a dev blog on that. Anyways, Swedish aircraft in War Thunder, the SAAB J29D, which is a jet-powered fighter. So, let's first start off by reading what they say here. Dear friends, we've got some great news. A new playable nation is coming to the game in War Thunder 1.93 Shark Attack, update Sweden. We're kicking off our roulette of Swedish military vehicles with aircraft, and in War Thunder update 1.93, you'll get the chance to be the first owners of aircraft from this new in-game nation. We're offering early access to Sweden's tech tree in 2 pre-order packs, where you'll get premium aircraft, unique decals, titles, and exclusive access to the testing of Swedish aircraft in the game. But, well, again, does it say right down here? Yes, the first 2 aircraft from the Swedish Air Forces will be available in upcoming update 1.93. The closed beta testing for Swedish Air Tech Tree will begin later in the following War Thunder update, so update 1.95. We'll see the release of the Swedish Aviation. Okay, anyways, as it says here, today we're going to tell you about an aircraft from one of these packs, the Swedish SAAB J29D. So hopefully they show off the Finnish aircraft in another dev vlog. Maybe it's already on the store, because the Swedish plane is already on the store. Let's go check and see if the Finnish one is too. Okay, so I've loaded into the website here, and as you can see, there is no... Well, this is page 2, but there's only listed the pre-order rank 5 jet. I do not see the other aircraft on the website anywhere, so that'll probably be listed when they make the announcement for that plane too. Anyways, here is the pre-order pack itself, so let's go to the store page instead, because we can get a better look at all the bonuses that come with it. So it's $49.99. So it's not a full-priced pack, but it's what you would expect from a jet pack. You get the SAAB J29D, which is a rank 5 Swedish premium jet, of course, which will be available after 1.93. You get 2,000 Golden Eagles and 15 days of premium time. And you also get a special decal, which you can see right here, and you also get the very nice sounding Viking title. Of course, those are both pre-order... Why is my fucking thing upside down? Those are both pre-order bonuses. So if you want these, you'll have to get them before... I don't know if it's going to be before the update or before the tech tree releases. For China, it was before the update, so keep that in mind. Okay, so let's continue on. Here's some history on the unit if you are interested. And then we can get some closer looks at the aircraft here. Okay, so here we've got the look at it. Now, it's a very interesting looking jet aircraft, to say the least. It's small, it's stubby, it's kind of chunky. And here they're showing off, of course, the new pilot model that's coming with the aircraft, which is nice. We're offering our players a modified prototype of the Swedish Barrel, the J29D. Compared to previous variants, it boasts new powerful engine and enhanced frontal armament. In terms of powertrain, the licensed Ghost engine has been replaced with the SFA RM2B engine with afterburner, possessing almost 25% greater thrust. This jet fighter is able to achieve slightly over 1,000 kilometers per hour at sea level with a 55 meters per second climb rate with afterburner enabled. Instead of 20mm cannons, the aircraft is fitted with British 30mm Aden cannons. From version B, the aircraft got wing-mounted racks for 75, 145, 150, and 180mm rockets for ground and naval targets, which you can obviously see loaded on some of these screenshots. The final product is a well-built jet fighter with excellent flight characteristics, powerful frontal armament for air battles, and assault suspensions for taking out ground forces. The J-29D's direct peers in the game are the American Sabre and the Soviet MiG-15 Bis. It is very bizarre to say that this thing is on par with those aircraft. Not in terms of statistics, but in terms of visuals. So I guess don't underestimate the little chunker. The J-29D displays bold individuality in every aspect. Its unusual appearance, its excellent combination of speed and maneuverability, as well as its versatility, which sets it apart from most other aircraft. The J-29D is a great first choice for getting to know the aircraft of Sweden. And here we can get some close-ups. You can see the 430mm cannons there, as well as the rockets on the wings. Here we get a closer view of the rockets themselves. And then we get to see its little butt. So, yeah, that's it on this aircraft in particular. But obviously the main announcement here is that Sweden is coming to War Thunder finally. And they'll be getting their aviation tech tree first. Of course, for me personally, as I'm sure most people probably agree, the ground forces tech tree for Sweden will probably be a little bit more in the way of what we're looking forward to. But you got to start somewhere, and because... you might say, well, China got air and ground together. Yeah, but those were already built tech trees, and they didn't come with any of the super uber unique stuff like the ZTZ-96 or anything like that. So for Sweden, it's probably going to be back to the classic old tech tree style, the way they release it. You start with planes, then come ground forces, you know, and then at a later date come naval forces and stuff like that. And I really look forward to seeing the Swedish ground forces. As for their aviation, I'm very interested to see what their tech tree looks like, and we've got, like I said, two pre-order vehicles. One of them's not available yet, but we've got their top tier one, or their high tier one rather, the jet, and then we'll get their Finnish aircraft next, which is the one that I would probably lean more towards myself personally, because it's early, it's not a post-war, it's not a jet or whatever. Because, I mean, we do have, you know, the ME-262 World War II style jets and stuff like that. Those are fine, but it's still jets that I mainly stick away from. So, we have a prop aircraft, let me put it that way. And it's also basically a Finnish BF-109. They explained it in the live stream as well. But see, the thing is I was actually in a voice call about a week or two ago where I was looking at various Finnish military vehicles in the voice call, and I came across that very aircraft that they're releasing for the Swedish tech tree, and I was like, holy shit, this thing looks like something pulled straight out of, you know, it looks like they combined an Italian fighter with a German 109 fighter, and yeah, I mean, when you combine two very powerful fighter aircraft together, yeah, and it's got German cannons, so there's nothing to complain about. Anywho, guys, that is it for 1.93's Swedish update sort of news post. If you haven't followed along with the official dev blogs yet, here are some other stuff that are coming with the next major update. For helicopters, we are getting the Italian Rank 6 pre-order A129. As their tech tree is not coming, but you will be able to get at least one of their helicopters, similar to how they're doing the Japanese tech tree. The Russians are getting a Rank 6 pre-order KA-50 premium Black Shark helicopter, as well as a Rank 7 standard MI-28N gunship for the Russian helicopter tech tree as well. Now, those are the only three helicopters in the live stream. They said that there's three new helicopters coming, so I'm still a little bit questioning what happened to the prototype Apache helicopter. Is that not ready to ship yet? You know, and it looks like we're not getting a longbow or anything with the update, but I guess maybe some things will be added a little bit later before the update releases, or we'll just have to wait until the next major update. As for other content, we of course also have the Rank 4 Premium Centurion Action 10 for the British tech tree, as well as the Rank 6 Vickers Mark 7 for the British tech tree. The Russians are getting the Rank 7 BMP-3 light tank, and the French are getting the 693A-B2 Rank 2 attacker aircraft. The United States is also getting their new Rank 5 heavy cruiser, the USS Pensacola. Yes, Rank 5 is being added to naval forces, and they also confirmed larger classes of ships. And we saw, again, some other new ships in the form of a new premium United States light cruiser and a new premium British light cruiser. They didn't show off, like, the Japanese tech tree, so I don't know if they're getting a premium light cruiser, you know, or if Germany's getting a premium light cruiser or anything, but at least the two nations that are getting Rank 5 are getting a premium light cruiser. Okay, so there you go, guys. Obviously, we're probably going to see some more dev blogs on, I'm hoping the ZTZ gets a dev blog, and there's some other vehicles that could also get dev blogs. Yes, the United States are getting the M1A2 Abrams as well. And like I said, Germany's getting a BMP, so it looks like finally East Germany's coming into the ground forces section of their tech tree. And also, of course, we need the other dev blog on the Finnish aircraft that's coming for the Swedish aviation tech tree. I would really like to see that thing in greater detail in the game, aside from what we saw in the thing. And I'm also very curious to see what the pre-order title will be, because you could there's just about anything you can do with Finnish words, and to have a Finnish title would be kind of badass. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below about Sweden coming to the game finally in the form of an aviation tech tree, and I will see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video times two. I said that twice. Yes.